We're giving you a little bit of a Wing Chun punch combinations, and people were thinking, well, what more can you do besides this? Well, I'm going to add in another punch to make it a little bit more rounded out. So we're looking at sot sao. We're looking at sot sao from the rear. Normally, sot sao, we like to do the longest hand and going out front. So I'm going to use this as a rear shot. So this motion, if you think about it, I'm just going up to here. Second one is going to go here. And the next one is going to go here. So this is a little, it's a variation if you think about a inverted Cuban uppercut. So Cuban uppercut typically is, if she's holding it like this, that's a Cuban uppercut. So I'm bringing that punch in from there. What we're doing here is we're just reversing it, and I'm going to extend it outward. A lot of the oomph you're going to get on this is because your elbow precedes the punch. It's carving the path. So if my elbow goes out here, that means I should be striking along a path that goes that way. So if I want to do this right, I need to have my elbow traveling in an upward path so that the base of my fist here, the edge of my fist here, hammers in just right. So again, sot sao from the beginning is here. There's going to be that slight movement forward. I'm going to do the inverse Cuban uppercut like that. Off of that, I'm going to trap and then back fist or guat choi. So here to here. Now all of these are trapping and forward energy strikes. So it's not something that I'm going to sit here and just practice over and over and not move toward my partner. In the beginning, that's something you want to do just so that you get the technique down, so you're not actually hitting your partner, so they can adjust to the movement and the timing as well. Because right off the bat there, see how she moves? That's what you want to do. This one carries through like this. I'm still on line here. That means I have everything directed toward center. I'm moving with a trap and then coming forward with the back fist. Her movement helps make this work, because quite honestly, if I'm going here and I'm hitting somebody, they're going to move. If I miss or she puts something else in the way, the Cuban upper, inverse Cuban uppercut is going to play with her. And then I'm going to trap whatever might have been in the way with the guat choi or the back fist. Okay, so that's something to add to your mix so that you're not just doing this. There's other combinations I'm going to be working and adding a little mix in there so that you as a Wing Chun practitioner will be able to modify it slightly so that you can do some surprising things. And we think that is a bit of a surprise, especially when we do it in sparring. Another comment here, just to make sure that you're aware, is she's trying to keep it so that the strikes are along center line, meaning so that when I'm training to strike somebody, I'm not training to strike them like you'll see some people doing this, throwing my punches way out here, throwing my punches way over here, when the person is here. Why the hell am I learning to do that? Some people say, well, you generate all this power. I've heard all the crap. It doesn't work. We're looking for efficiency. And efficiency is, if you want to train the musculature for that, we use band training. We use a lot of other conditioning, core conditioning. Come on, put them in. That's it, yeah. To get the strength and power, one thing we don't do is we don't take the mentality of ingraining structurally incorrect mechanics off of a punch because somebody's too lazy to work the bands or doesn't even know about it. So you want to keep it as close to what you're actually striking. This is sensible training. So when I'm coming through here, I'm hitting there. My next one is here. It's along where I would hit. That makes sense, right? And then there. And her movement helps me in my progression forward. So none of this none of this, none of that. Yeah, because that does not train me in the end to functionally hit this or anything along that center. You don't want to train that way. Okay, if you like that, please thumbs up. Hit subscribe if you haven't. It really does help. The more subscribers we have and the more interaction, if you like this, please put the comments below too. And if you want to see something else, that's where a lot of this comes from, is people see something that they want to see from me to see if I can blend it or mix it, or if I can find something functional out of what they're doing that wasn't working for them, inspiring, that sort of thing. Just let me know. And I'll do my best to help you. Thank you. Yeah.